Today we're going to be discussing duplicate dominant epistasis. Epistasis is when two loci contribute to the expression of a particular phenotype in an unexpected way. What is unexpected in epistasis is that one allele expression at one locus can mask or alter the outcome of allele expression at another locus.
This glass of water will represent a colorless precursor of a particular species of glassware. We will observe the genotypes contributing to the trait of color of liquid in this glass. This almond milk will represent enzyme A, which is produced when uppercase A allele is present at locus A in the genotype. When lowercase a allele is present, it does not contribute to the production of any enzymes altering the liquid color. This empty teal mug represents the lowercase a's contribution to the phenotype, which is nothing. This 2% milk will represent enzyme B, which is produced when uppercase B allele is present at locus B in the genotype. When lowercase b allele is present, it does not contribute to the production of any enzymes altering liquid color. This empty blue mug represents lowercase b's contribution to the phenotype, which is nothing.
To demonstrate duplicate dominant epistasis, we will explore what happens when different combinations of alleles are present in the genotype of this species of glassware. Let's start with homozygous recessive at both loci. This means the genotype is a, little b, little b. Neither recessive allele A nor recessive allele B produce any polypeptides that result in a color change in the colorless precursor, so no change will occur. Now let's say at locus A, at least one of the alleles in the particular genotype is the uppercase A. Because the uppercase A allele is present, enzyme A, almond milk, is produced in the individual. This produces a white phenotype in the glass as opposed to the colorless precursor. Now let's say the uppercase A allele was not present, but at least one uppercase B allele is. Because the uppercase B allele is present, enzyme B, 2% milk, is produced in the individual. This produces the same white phenotype in the glass as enzyme A did. Lastly, if at least one uppercase A allele is present and at least one uppercase B allele is present, both enzyme A and enzyme B are produced in the individual, still producing that same white phenotype in the glass. If we were to do a dihybrid cross with this trait, only one out of 16 offspring would remain colorless, while the other 15 would have at least one uppercase allele between the two loci, giving them the white phenotype. If we were to complete a cross between big A, little a, big B, and little a, big B, little b, 4 out of 4, or 1 out of 1 offspring would have at least one dominant allele between the two loci. This means that 100% of the offspring would be white, and there is a 0% chance that these two individuals could have colorless offspring. That's all for this week. Be sure to tune in next week for Population Genetics and Hardy-Weinberg Equilibrium.